Software. As announced, I start to translate my Unreal Engine tutorial from German to English. This video is the real start of the tutorials. I show you in this video where to get the Unreal Engine and how to start and open the first scene. I myself really like the engine and I want to share my passion and knowledge with you. The Unreal Engine is a free to use game engine, but you have to get a license if you want to publish a game. With the publishing license, you can create a game and sell it with 5% royalty to Epic Games if the game succeeds. In this and the following tutorials, I show you how to get the engine, how to work with this, and we get familiarized with the user interface. After those, we will focus more on how to work with assets in the engine and how we get assets in the engine. But first things first, where we can get the Unreal Engine. The engine is made by Epic Games, so let's go and visit their homepage. By the way, I linked the site on the description down below. We have to log in first. For the people who don't have an account yet, you should make one. Here on the top right button, we can log in or register ourselves. One really nice thing is, Epic Games also works together with Quixel, and with this account we also can use it too. With Quixel we can get assets for our projects, but more on a further tutorial. Back to topic. We have an account now. Now we go to the top bar and select Unreal Engine. Press Get Started, until we can choose our license we want to use. Both versions are free to use, but as I said before, if you want to publish a game, you need the publishing license. If you just want to learn and have fun, you can use the creator's license. I choose the publishing license just in case I will publish something. Choose the destination of download. I already have it, so I will stop here. You download the setup and install it like every other program or game you have on your PC. Okay, after installing is done, we have the Epic Game Launcher on our PC now. Let's open it. As always, we start with the homepage of the launcher. A nice addition is Epic Games offers various games here for free, so you should check it out from time to time. Maybe you find something you are interested in. But keep in mind, this recording is a little older, because I used my original footage and voice over it, to be sure both versions are similar to each other and maybe to make it a little bit easier for me. Okay, enough advertising for games. Back to what we're actually here for, the Unreal Engine. On the left side we can choose the Unreal Engine to get further. We start with the main site where news to Unreal are shared, like this time fresh news to the Unreal Engine 5. This year we will see what this engine really can do. Here you also can find different things to learn, many things are documented. Those are all in English, and this was actually the reason I started with the German tutorials, because those are hard to find. And now we are here back in English. It's kind of ironic. Next option is the marketplace. Here you also can get different things for your project. From assets to plugins, some are free, some are chargeable. We will take a closer look at all of this in a later tutorial. We will also talk about what to consider when we're using third-party assets in our project. And finally, our library. Here are all the versions of the engine, the projects you create, and all the stuff you bought on the marketplace. I already have some things here. You probably will start with three entry rows. By pushing on this yellow plus, you will get the newest version to install. I recommend you to start with the newest version at this point. At the time I record this footage, the newest version was the 4.25.0. The newest version at the moment is the 4.26 Chaos. You should install this version because Epic Games will probably work more on this than on the other versions, since the Chaos engine is finally being included. Some features are already been taken from the other versions, like the various game modes we will take a look later. If you already have a project in the older version, you can upgrade this project to the newest version you have on your computer without a problem. The next time you open the scene, Unreal will ask you if you want to upgrade it to the newest version, and you can duplicate and upgrade it. Because of this duplication, you have no risk to lose something if it don't work. If there was a plugin and upgrading don't work, you can go back, get rid of the problem and take another try. Speaking of duplication, if you work on a huge project, you should make some backups after every huge step and save it on another device like an external hard drive or a cloud. Just in case something happens and your work gets corrupted. I learned this on the hard way, so learn from my mistakes. I lost a lot of progress a few days before a deadline and I could not catch up again. It will take some time to install the version you choose. And I recommend to restart your computer after it's done. Another tip for me, a lazy girl, is to create a desktop shortcut. You can do this by clicking on the yellow arrow on the engine version you want to create a link for. Small window will open and here you can find the options you need. Also, I recommend to always close the launcher after you start the engine or the game, because it always draws power from your PC. I close the launcher and open the Unreal Editor I put on the desktop. We can now choose a project we want to work with if we have one. Underneath we get some options for a new project. Because I'm a game artist, we will focus on games. Every option has a separate features to make the work a bit easier to achieve the different goals. Now we can select a template to our games we want to create. This feature is only left on the KS version of the engines, and this was one point you should use the newest version. Like the options before, every template has a new features it will offer us to work with. I advise against using the MP project. To add something the other template gave us for free is a bit complicated. Think a bit about your goal, what do you want to achieve, and select the one who fits your project the best. If you just want to test things, make some nice scenes, or don't really know what you actually want, I recommend to use the first person or the third person. You will get a working gunner with the first person and a playable mannequin in the third person to work around and have fun. Next steps are the project settings. We start with the blueprints. Just select C++ if you have a programmer who can program in this language. Good to know here is that Unreal has its own dialect in C++. The rest, please use the blueprints option. I will show you some nice things you can do with blueprints sometimes. We want something nice to see, so we stay with the maximum quality. If your computer can use ray tracing, you can enable it. The rest of us stays without it. Here we can choose if the end goal of our project is a desktop or a mobile game. I stay with desktop. Just use the mobile option when you are sure you want to make a mobile game. And the last option is if you want the starter content or not. I recommend to use the starter content. You will get some assets you can work with from the beginning. Below the options, we can choose the location where the project will be saved and the name. And here it is, our first project we can work in. You always get a simple scene at the start. Every template has a different one, so you can test the features at the start. I choose the third person template, so I get a little parkour place and a mannequin. We can play in the scene by pushing play on the top row. Now we can play the mannequin and run around and jumping around. The basic things you need in the third person game. And because this content is made especially for this engine, everything can be changed and things can be added. In the following tutorial, we will take a look at the user interface. As you see, here are a lot of things. After we have familiarized ourselves with the interface, we will deal with how to import assets and work with them. Yeah, we will start to work with the content the Unreal Engine gave us, and then a little bit later, how to import assets and work with them. As you see, there are many things to learn, and we will go through it step by step. And I hope I can help you with some questions you had, or get you interested into working with this awesome engine. If there's anything you don't understand, or you just have another question, you are free to leave me a comment and I try to answer it as soon as I can. Thank you for your attention and leave a thumbs up if you like the tutorials, and if you don't want to miss the next part, please subscribe. Have a nice day, you all. And a huge thank you to my only Patreon, Ferilis. You are awesome. Thank you for your support.